أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. All praises due to Allah and may His peace and blessings be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To all of our brothers and sisters there we say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And by the way, that includes our brothers and sisters in Islam as well as our brothers and sisters who may not be of the Muslim faith, our brothers and sisters in humanity. May the peace and blessings of God be upon all of you. We are talking about shackles. And last time we talked about shackles and we said that these are self-inflicted shackles that we would like to discuss. And we said that shackles, the sad part behind them is that they pin us down. They bring us down or they keep us down from reaching our potential. And that is why as Muslims we said that the theology of Islam is liberating. The teachings of Islam are liberating. And the aim of Islam is to liberate all those who associate with this religion. And last time we spoke about what we call mental shackles. And they come in the form of grief, depression, worry, and anxiety, and what have you. And this time we're talking about a different type of shackles. And we're talking about a specific one, and that is the issue of debts. As you know, we have started with the hadith or the prophetic statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, where he starts by saying, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika, O Allah, I seek refuge in you. And at the end of the hadith, or towards the end of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, وَالدَّيْن ضَلَعِ الدَّيْن وَقَهْرِ الرِّجَالِ, being overwhelmed with debts. Debts is our topic of the day. In Islam, the idea of taking a loan or taking a debt, if there is no need, is highly detested. And the teaching is that you ought to avoid taking debts as much as you can. Meaning, in other words, that you live within your means. The idea is, if it's not necessary, if it's not a need, then maybe you should do without it. It was said that one time the Prophet, peace be upon him, would make the prayers and he would say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-dayni wa min al-kufr. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from being in debts or from being a disbeliever. Or from debts and disbelief. A companion overheard this statement. He came to him and he said, Prophet of Allah, do you equate debts with disbelief? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Na'am, ayu'dalu al-kufru bid-dayn aw ayu'dalu ad-daynu bil-kufru? Faqala sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Na'am. And the Prophet, peace upon him, emphatically said, yes, that is the case. In other words, you neither want to be financially bankrupt and at the same time you do not want to be spiritually bankrupt as well. It was also said that one time the Prophet, peace be upon him, was invited to pray for a janazah or in a funeral. And he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, stepped forward to pray for the deceased. And he looked back and he asked the people. He said, did this man, the person who just passed away, did he leave any debts? And one man said, yes, Prophet of Allah, he has not paid me back 2 golden coins. And the Prophet stepped back and he said, somebody else should lead these prayers. Jabir ibn Abdullah was present. He stepped forward and he said, Prophet of Allah, I will take care of his debts. Please, Prophet of Allah, go ahead and proceed with the prayers for this person. Now the idea is, the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us a lesson here, that there are consequences for taking debts and not paying them back, especially if you have the ability to do so. But again, the point is to illustrate that in Islam, taking debts is highly disliked. It is highly detested, especially if there is no need for it. It is also said that it is narrated about Jesus, peace be upon him, our beloved Prophet, that he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, he who goes a borrow, goes a sorrow. Also in the hadith, it was said that the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, أقل من الدين تعيش حرة. He said, borrow less, you live a free man. There is a sense of freedom when you have no debts. There is a sense of freedom when you owe nothing to anybody else that is out there. And they say that, you know, debts is like a lie. The first lie requires other forms of lies to cover up for it. And the first debt, or the first debt, is usually an invitation to other forms of debt that will be brought along with it. The sad part that in our day, or today, in today's world, that we view debt as an inconvenience. In reality, debt is a calamity. And unless we see it as a calamity, our chances are very slim in making sure that we are financially liberated. Now remember, this has nothing to do with a person whether they are paying interest or they're not paying interest. The fact that they have taken debts in itself, Islam sees this as detrimental, jeopardizing. It is jeopardizing and compromising your freedom. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam again says, أَقِلَّ مِنَ الدَّيْنِ تَعِشْ حُرًّا. Said, borrow less, you live a free man. The beautiful statement here is that where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam refers to the idea of being debt-free as liberating, as a free man. You see this in the form of big corporations. You see this in the form of countries. You see this in the form of individuals. The idea is to liberate yourself. Unless there is a need for it, do not. Please, do not borrow any money that you do not need. It used to be that people would borrow money to cover their necessities, to cover basic necessities and dire needs. But nowadays, that is not the case, especially in the form of credit cards, which we will talk about, by the way, at length, inshallah, in some other time. But at this time, we are just laying the ground that borrowing money, if there is no need for it, it is highly detested in Islam. Not only this, but keep in mind this, the following story. It was said that one time a man came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and he said, O Prophet of Allah, if I were to die in a battlefield, in the path of Allah, meaning that there was a noble cause behind what it is that I was doing, will I be forgiven of my sins? And the Prophet ﷺ said, yes, that will be the case. The man left. The Prophet ﷺ called upon him again. He said, كَيْفَ قُلْتَ? He said, what was your question again? And he said, Prophet of Allah, if I were to die in the battlefield, meaning that I was involved in a noble cause, will Allah forgive all my sins? And the Prophet ﷺ said, yes, Allah will overlook everything else, said, unless debts that you have not paid back. Also look into the idea of the longest ayah in the Quran. And just to accommodate people out there who may not be familiar with the teachings of Islam, the book of Muslims is called the Quran. It is made out of different chapters, 114, and the chapters are broken into ayahs or verses. And the longest verse, which is almost about a page long, speaks specifically about this idea of debts. Now remember, on the part of the borrower, Islam says that you should not borrow unless there is a need to do so. On the part of the lender, we refer to this as min uqud al-irfaq, that this is a contract where there is really no benefit in it to the lender other than it's an act, a pure act of benevolence, meaning that when you give for the sake of helping this person. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would highly speak about this. من فرج عن مؤمن كربة من كرب الدنيا فرج الله عنه كربة من كرب يوم القيامة. He who helps a following believer or a fellow believer in alleviating from him some of the calamities of this world, Allah will help that person, or Allah will alleviate from that person a calamity of the calamities of the day of judgment. So the idea is, on the one hand, it tells the borrower, please do not borrow unless there is a need to do so. On the part of the lender, it tells him that this is such a benevolent act. It's an act that is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please do give money for those who are in need of it. Not only that, but the Quran clearly says, وَإِنْ كَانَ ذُو عُسْرَةٍ فَنَظِرَةٌ إِلَى مَيْسَرًا. But if the borrower is in dire need and they have no ability to pay back for their debts, Allah recommends and Allah commands that the lender be given, or for the lender to give the borrower some extra time to pay back for their loans. Not only that, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man istadala amwal al-nasi yuridu ada'aha adallahu anhu." He who borrows from people with the intention that one day they will pay back whenever they have the ability or whenever the appointed term comes, but the person has like this sincere intention that he is borrowing with it in mind that he will pay back, but for some reason he is not able to pay back, the Prophet ﷺ promised, أَدَّ Allah will pay back on his behalf. وَمَنْ إِسْتَدَانَ أَمْوَالَ النَّاسِ يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا أَتْلَفَهُ اللَّهُ. But he who borrows from people with the intent at the time of borrowing the money, you know that you neither have the ability nor the desire. The ability and the desire. The Prophet ﷺ said, a person who takes the money of people, and then he said, يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا, with the intent of ruining them or ruining their wealth or not paying them back, it said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to ruin that person back. Meaning that if this is how you're going to act, this is how you are going to be paid back. So you see the teachings of Islam in a sense that it tells the person, please do not borrow. But when the lender is approached, those who have, when they are approached to please share and give, Islam says, please do so. One thing that you keep in mind is that there should be no men, meaning that you ought not to remind them that I have lent you this money, I've given you this money, publicly shame them, publicly remind them that this is going on. Islam says, no, that cannot be the case. Also, Islam says that you should not charge them any extra amount, in addition to what it is that you have given them, because that is seen as a form of interest. In fact, some scholars, and this is a principle, it's a bit debatable, it says, كُلُّ قَرْضٍ جَرَّ نَفْعًا فَهُوَ رِبًا. It said, any form of debt that brings with it to the lender any form of benefit other than the amount that they have given be paid back to them, it said that this is considered to be a form of interest. Such as, can you please lend me $10? Oh, I will lend you $10, but can you please wash my car? Washing the car and giving me $10, I will get my $10 back. But in addition to the $10, I am also getting a free car wash, and this is seen as manfa'ah. It is seen as benefit that I gained as a result of me giving people this amount of money back. Like I said, this is a topic that we will discuss, inshallah, again more, especially in the form of credit cards later on. But until then, the idea is this. Unless there is a need, please do yourself a favor and apply what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَقِلَّ مِنَ الدَّيْنِ تَعِشْ حُرًّا. Borrow less, you live a free man. This is Yasser Farzaqa reminding you to liberate yourself. Thank you for being with us here today. And until we meet, inshallah, next time, we say so long. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.